rien à voir avec l'image que nous avons.
Nothing like people's idea of a medical team in a tent under makeshift conditions.
Dans des conditions précaires.
Broadly speaking, this is peacekeeping. At the moment, I think that's the best description, yes. Colonel Dr. Pierre Aubert is in charge of the French medical and surgical group of the NATO Kosovo force. His 34 years of service as a military doctor have taken him to many different places, including Bosnia, Chad, Ivory Coast, and even Afghanistan. Now he's ensuring the smooth running of medical facilities with a staff of 30. Based at the Plana camp in the north of Kosovo. This hospital is an essential part of the medical logistical support for KFOR operations. The Plana Medical Group is one of three KFOR military hospitals. For their part, the Germans and Americans have similar medical facilities in service in Prizren and in Bonstil in the south of Kosovo. The first point to be understood is that our primary purpose is to look after KFOR military personnel. That's the absolute inescapable priority mission. In addition, we're able to treat local people. Kosovo is a small area in the Balkans, about one-third the size of Belgium. It has 2 million inhabitants. About 92% are Albanians, 5% Serbs, and 3% other ethnic groups. After the unilateral declaration of independence of Kosovo on the 17th of February 2008, the NATO-led KFOR has remained there to help establish a stable, democratic, peaceful Kosovo. KFOR works in close cooperation with the population of Kosovo, the United Nations, the European Union, and other international players. In 2009, KFOR comprises nearly 15,000 people.
KFOR is, as you know, in Kosovo under the UN resolution, the 1244. Our mission is to maintain a safe, secure environment and the freedom of movement for all the individuals and the community, Kosovo-wide. So I think that nothing has changed, in effect.
The town of Mitrovica, divided by the Ibar River, has always been the main focus of friction between the two communities. 40,000 Serbs to the north and 80,000 Albanians to the south warily face one another under the eyes of KFOR patrols. Day after day, soldiers are on watch to douse any spark of violence which might set the town alight. Here we are by the crossing made by the French for access to the district of the Three Towers, just behind me, a multi-ethnic area inhabited both by Albanian and Serbian Kosovars, a source of much tension in the past. And to my left, you can see the Austerlitz Bridge, where we end our patrol. In fact, there have been few incidents over recent months. It's mainly a matter of talking to the people and showing the presence of KFOR. This keeps the area secure, protects minorities and religious and historical sites, and supports the deployment of the European Union Rule of Law Mission in Kosovo, EULEX. After 10 years of violence, Kosovo is in the process of reconstruction, and the local authorities have often seen NATO as an essential partner. KFOR is NATO's second most important operation after Afghanistan. General Yakovlev commands Multinational Task Force North. A practical man, he knows the difficulty of keeping peace in this region in transition.
Au début, lorsque la KFOR est rentrée, il y avait beaucoup de réfugiés qui rentraient en même temps.
At the start, when KFOR came, lots of refugees were returning at the same time. The health system had completely collapsed. You couldn't find the doctors, who were just faces in the crowd with no equipment and surgeries that had been destroyed. So for a few months, KFOR provided a lot of emergency medical aid on humanitarian grounds. Now that people have resettled in their homes, more or less, and a health system is being built or rebuilt, there's no longer the humanitarian requirement.
Ce besoin-là, le besoin humanitaire n'existe plus.
But Kosovo, which lives on international aid, is also a social time bomb. Its GDP per head is among the lowest in the world, and unemployment exceeds 40%. Every day, many people like this come to consult the French medical group.
Vous parlez français?
Я прочитаю французский.
Parfait.
About 15 to 20 patients a day are seen, and at least 120 a week. Equal care is given to soldiers and civilians, Serbs and Albanians, with the same skill and degree of urgency. We're not here to compete with existing local facilities. We should be seen as an additional service. We respond to the demand when needs can't be met locally. These failings are known to Bajram Recepi, the mayor of Mitrovica. A former prime minister, he fully understands that improving the health of the population has a positive knock-on effect in other areas. But just now, future prospects are not clear.
Somebody who is very familiar with medicine, they know that something between 30 and 50 years, doctors are most productive, they are mature. They do operation, they do properly, they work. Now, because of this institutional gap, that from 1990, many of doctors, they were expelled by their working places. We had some old generation which are before of retirement, and we have young doctors which they have not enough experience. We miss this most productive generation.
Rather than an armed conflict, what is happening in Kosovo is now the prelude to building institutions and the economy. And KFOR's involvement in reconstruction seems a major advantage. You can see it with the patients, and especially their families. When one of our former patients says, "I will tell people to come and be treated here." It's not that we do a better job than others, but our work does help KFOR gain acceptance in Kosovo. 5 p.m. Colonel Dr. Pierre Aubert has just finished his surgery. His team have treated about 15 patients. Knowledge of the surgery has spread throughout the surrounding communities by word of mouth. And they know they'll have even more patients tomorrow.